In the last two decades, more than 100,000 people have contracted Lyme disease, resulting in about 700 deaths. The weird thing is, we used to have a cheap, readily available, and even mass-producible Lyme vaccine. So what went wrong that's caused 100,000 people to suffer? You guessed it, anti-vaxxers. Let's talk about that. According to the CDC, in 2006, there were just under 20,000 confirmed cases of Lyme disease. By 2015, the number had grown to nearly 29,000. And these are just the confirmed cases. Estimates suggest that as many as 300,000 people may have been infected in the last year alone. So what's behind the near 50% rise in cases over the last decade? Well, climate change has increased the range of ticks, most notably the deer ticks that carry the disease. And year by year, humans have developed further into the woodlands these critters call home. All this has resulted in people running into ticks more often. But as cases grow, many think back to a time long ago when we had a Lyme vaccine. Well, not even that long ago. The name of the vaccine was LYMErix, and it was approved by the FDA in 1998. After three injections, it could protect people against the disease about 90% of the time. When LYMErix first hit the market, hundreds of thousands of people got the vaccine, even though the three injections cost a few hundred dollars. If you're confused why people had to pay out of pocket for vaccines, well, hello to my non-American audience. How's it going? The vaccine actually worked in a pretty unusual way, neutralizing the bacteria that caused Lyme disease inside the tick's body, rather than neutralizing it within the person's body. The same year that LYMErix hit the market, that famous and now retracted and widely debunked study came out in the Lancet, supposedly linking vaccines to autism. At the same time, some people were beginning to report that LYMErix was causing arthritis in hamsters, and a study came out suggesting that certain people might have an increased risk of developing arthritis after taking the drug. Media reports rapidly spread the news, and anti-vaccine activists smelled blood. Naturally, the placebo effect took hold, and people who had been vaccinated with LYMErix began to complain that it was the cause of their joint pain. Although later studies would show this wasn't the case, the number of people who had been vaccinated with LYMErix and developed joint pain was totally consistent with the background 23% of American adults who naturally develop arthritis. But this evidence was too little too late, and the damage was already done to the vaccine's reputation. Because of anti-vax rage and a very public lawsuit against the company that developed LYMErix, sales fell from more than 1 million units in 1999 to only 10,000 just 2 years later. At those volumes, the drug was no longer profitable, and the manufacturer halted production. 2 decades later, and we still don't have a new FDA-approved Lyme vaccine. Meanwhile, the number of reported cases of Lyme disease continues to rise. As of right now, the best anyone can do is to use insect repellent and check for ticks after walking in the woods or tall grass. Since this video will inevitably be brigaded by anti-vaxxers, if you like the video, be sure to click the like button and drop a comment down below to help fight the good fight with me. And if you want to see our whole collection of quick bits, check out our playlist here. As always, have a great day, and remember, there's always more to learn.